Good morning everyone. So today we will be discussing about the FIR filter designing. So while we are designing the FIR filters, there are certain considerations which we have to take. In general, when we design the FIR filters, the modulus of H omega, it is considered to be 1. So when we consider this as the 1, that means, if you see, we have discussed previously, H of omega may be written as Y of omega divided by X of omega, right? So, this becomes modulus of Y omega divided by modulus of X omega is equal to 1. So, from here, we get that modulus of Y omega is equal to modulus of X omega, okay? So, this is an important thing in the FIR filter designing, okay? So, what is the significance of this equation where we are talking about that modulus of Y omega is equal to modulus of X omega? It means that there is no loss of signal frequency components when you process the signal using the FIR filters. Okay, this is an important consideration that when there is when you are using FIR filter, you will have no loss of the signal frequency components. Okay. Second thing is that the designing of the FIR filter, it is a direct process. Okay. In our later lectures, we will see, on the contrary, when we talk about IIR filters over here, so what happens that first we have to design a prototype low pass filter, and then we have to perform frequency transformations to design the not only the low pass filter but also the high pass filter, band pass filter, band reject filter. Now you will say, sir, already we have designed the prototype low pass filter, then why we need to design the low pass filter in the after the frequency in the transformations? This is because the prototype low pass filter is being designed as per our convenience, and then we apply the frequency transformation so that we get the filter with desired characteristics. Okay, so this is the second important criteria of the or the important factor related to the FIR filter designing, that is the designing of the FIR filter designing process. It is a direct method, not like the IIR filter where we have to apply a lot of mathematical operations to get to the desired systems. Okay. Third point, when we design FIR filters, we can design the filters individually and separately. Okay. So individually and separately means you get the characteristics of the filter, and from the characteristics or the parameters of the filter, you can individually design the system. Okay. And separately means like in the IIR filter, you design a low pass filter and then you go to high pass filter or band pass filter or band reject filter. You don't have to do this thing. So if you want to design the low pass filter, you can design the low pass filter directly. If you want to design the high pass filter, you can design the high pass filter. Okay. So individually means low pass filter. If you want to design low pass filter, you design the low pass filter. If you want to design the high pass filter, you design the high pass filter. Okay. So that is individually, and separately means you do not have to go for the transformation and all other things. Now the next important factor over here is that when we talk about H of omega in the polar coordinate, it may be represented as m multiplied by e to the power minus j omega n. Okay. However, in our first consideration, we have said that the modulus of the H omega, which is basically the magnitude of H omega, it is 1. So we can write it down in this fashion. e to the power minus of j omega n is, okay, so h of omega, it becomes e to the power minus j omega n. So in the simplistic form, if we compare it with e to the power minus j theta, so what we get? We get that omega n is equal to this phase is equal to your this one. Phase angle is equal to theta omega. Okay, so where this theta, it is basically the phase component of the system. This is basically the phase component of the system. Okay, now this phase h of omega, it is given by theta omega. Now theta omega, it is basically minus of omega n. Okay, now from here there are two considerations. This time, this n, it is called the time factor. It is called the time factor. Okay, now is this time factor can be represented directly as n equals to minus of theta omega by omega. Okay, now this is nothing but your tau p. Okay, what is tau p? Tau p is basically the phase delay. Okay, tau p is basically the phase delay. Okay, so tau p is equal to minus of theta omega by omega. Okay, again, if we differentiate the first thing, we can say again get n is sorry this should be equals to n is equals to minus of theta omega by omega, which can be given by tau g, where tau g is the group delay. Tau g is the group delay. Okay, now if both tau p and tau g, they are constant, that means the filter is a linear filter. Okay, so if tau p and tau g both are constant, then they are, these type of filters, they are regarded as linear filter. Okay, now what is the consideration? If you see, the consideration is if n increases, your minus of d omega, d theta omega by d omega, it decreases. Also if n increases, your minus of theta omega by omega, this also decreases. So the combination of these two gives us with a constant phase filter. This gives us a constant phase filter, and it is the most important property of the FIR filter. It is the most important property of the FIR filter. Okay, IIR filters, they are non-linear filters. That means they do not have a constant phase relationship. Okay, so the constant phase filters, or the linear phase nature of the FIR filter, is the most important criteria of the FIR filter to be used in various applications. Okay, lastly, over here there are no specific rules actually. Okay, so the actual cutoff frequency, we cannot determine from the designing method. Okay, also the order of the filter cannot be determined in an efficient manner while we are designing the FIR filters using the filter parameters which are being given. So what happens is that the designing of the FIR filter is usually by trial and error method, okay, it is usually by trial and error method. However, there is one method which is regarded as the Kaiser method. It is basically the empirical formula based method, and it is used for the FIR filter design. Okay. However, the Kaiser method is a very complex method and it is a tedious process. Okay. Lastly, if you consider the thing, if you look into the sixth point, is that we do not have the actual cutoff frequencies and order of the filter, we cannot find out. One of the most disadvantages thing is that if you are given with a specific filter characteristics, so for a specific filter characteristics, what we have is that the order of the FIR filter it is very high, okay, as compared to the IIF filter. Okay, the reason being in IIF filter we have the opportunity to design we have the opportunity to place both the poles and the filters at our desired location. However, in our previous class we have discussed that when we deal with FIR filter, all the poles they are present at the origin, right? So why that is so? I will again give you the example. Suppose for an FIR filter, you are given with the transfer function HZ, which is equals to say 1 plus AZ inverse plus BZ to the power minus 2 and all this and so on. Say for example, we restrict ourselves to the second order FIR filter. Then if I have to bring out or if I have to find out the placement of the poles and zeros, I have to convert it into the Z terms. So how we can do it? So we have to divide both the numerator and the denominator with Z to the power, the highest order of the or the highest power of the Z inverse. Okay. So over here we are not giving the negative terms, okay? So we will multiply both numerator and denominator with Z square. So what we get Z square plus AZ plus B divided by Z square, right? Now when we want to find out the poles, then this denominator would be equated to 0. So that would give Z at Z equals to plus minus 0, you will be having this thing. That means basically you are having at Z equals to 0 and 0, you are having two poles. So both the poles, they are present at the origin. If you even increase the order of this filter, the same thing will happen. So Z to the power n, it will be equal to 0. So you will be having the repeated poles at Z equals to 0. Okay. Now what is the significance of this? This is an important thing. What is the significance of the poles being placed at the origin? Okay. So say, okay, So this is the real Z, and we have the imaginary Z, right? And we are placing repeated poles at the origin. Say for example, let us take the first the simplistic case where we have a single pole at the origin. So in our previous classes we have seen that the distance of the pole to the frequency components, they play an important role in the filter designing, right? Anyone has any problem with that?
No sir.
Okay, good.
No sir.
No sir.
Now here comes the interesting fact. If you look into this pole and if you look into the distance from 0 to pi, everywhere it is having a value of 1. That means when we place the poles at the zeros, these poles, it is affecting all the frequency components in a similar manner. So there is no differential activity of the poles or the differential behavior of the pole towards a particular frequency. That means it is allowing all the frequencies to pass through. Right? It is allowing all the frequencies to pass through. Now, if you place only a pole at the origin, it would lead to the formation of a filter or designing of a filter which is regarded as all pass filter. Okay. I hope everyone knows about all pass filter. Anyone who does not know?
Sir, I don't know.
You don't know? So you tell me what I have just told.
Sir, if we place the pole at this 0, 0, then it will be all pass filter.
This is all pole at the origin.
Yes, sir.
Then tell me next word. You place the pole at the origin. Next word. Anyone else?
The magnet is not affecting the frequency axis. Hello. It allow all frequency to pass through the.
Maybe can anyone explain it in a bit clear manner, in a more detailed fashion?
Sir, it will having a distance 1 from at every frequency component. So it will allow to pass every frequency component in the same manner.
Yeah, exactly. Now have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So. So, in this FIR filter then, since pole is not affecting any, any of the frequency components in a differential manner, so all the frequency components, they are treated in a simplistic, in a similar manner, okay? However, if you look into the phase characteristics, which is minus of omega t, this angle, it is basically minus of omega t, okay? Why minus? Because it is going in the anti-clockwise manner, okay? So minus of omega t, the phase component will be minus of omega t. Now if you place another pole, then it will be minus of 2 omega t, another pole at the origin, okay? So only the phase component it is changing, but we are not changing the amplitude response or the magnitude response. Okay. Now you will ask then how this filter behave in a different manner. It behaves in a different manner by the placement of the zeros. By the placement of the zeros, we create an what you call, we create a situation where the placement of the zeros itself, it results in the development of the, or the designing of the filters with different characteristics. Okay, so in some textbooks you will find that the placement of the zeros helps in designing the FIF filter. That is a correct statement. Okay, so even though poles are present, they do not play an effect, or they do not have an effect on the magnitude response of the filter, because all of them, they are placed at the origin. So the magnitude response of the filters, they are being manipulated in of the FIF filter are being manipulated by the placement of the zeros. Okay. So we are talking about the filter characteristics. So we have talked about, as compared to the IR filter, the order of the FIR filter is higher. Okay. Now, if we again look over here in this equation, I have one equation over here. Okay. If I increase the order of the filter, what we are, I am doing, I am increasing the mathematical computational or mathematical complexity. Right? So when I am doing this, I am increasing the mathematical complexity. So when I am talking about that the order of the FIR filter is high as compared to the IR filters, what it says, that this filter is having high complexity. Okay, that means the computational burden is higher. Okay, mathematical complexity is higher, that means the mathematical burden will be higher. So this is one of the disadvantages, okay, of the FIR filter. But the major advantage is the that it is having the linear phase system, or it is FIR filters are the linear filters. Okay, however, since the mathematical complexity of the FIR filters, they are high, what happens is that in many cases, the researchers would like to use IIR filter if some phase distortions are acceptable within the passband of the IIR filters. Okay, that means when we talk about the linear phase filter, linear phase filter we would like to have, but that comes with a cost. What is the cost? Cost is the, there is an increased mathematical complexity, and so if you want to implement the filter, FIR filter, you will be needing better quality digital signal processors to implement those filters, right? Now, if you can trade off with some of your distortion, if you accept some of the distortions which are being introduced by the IIR filters, then many researchers or the many devices, they prefer to implement IIR filter in comparison to the FIR filter. In any case, where the acceptance of the distortion which are being introduced by the IIR filters is not acceptable at all, under that condition the FIR filters are preferred. Okay. So till now, anything you'd like to ask me? If you have any anything to discuss?
No, okay.
Now, when we talk about the types of FIR filter, we have four types of FIR filter: type 1, type 2, type 3, and type 4. Okay. Now, type 1 filter, the order of the filter is n. Okay. Whereas the length of the filter, it is n plus 1. Why this is so? If you see over here, what is the order of the filter? Order of the filter, I have told that the highest power of the equation, whether in the numerator or the denominator. Okay. So of the z. So over here it is 2. Over here it is the 2. Okay. So the order of the filter is 2. However, the length of the filter, that means how many coefficients are there? The number of the coefficients of the FIR filter are 1, 2, 3. That means the length of the filter, it becomes 2 plus 1, which is basically 3. So when you have the order of the filter, your length will always be given by n plus 1, where order is given by capital N and length is given by L. Okay. So order, if order is even, then length would be odd. Okay. And in this case, our Hn is equal to H of capital N minus N, okay, which is basically the symmetric in nature. Okay. So what it says, H of N is equal to H of N minus N. Okay. So what is Hn? What is Hn?
Impulse response.
Okay, yeah, good. Anyone who does not know in Hn? Okay, good. Everyone knows. So the impulse response of the systems are symmetric. And what do you mean by this? You mean so if you see over here, in this case, H of 0 is equal to H of, in this case, we are having the total length as 4. N is length is odd. Yeah. Order is 4, so we will be having H of 4, n is 0, so this is 0. So if you see, H of 0 equals to H of 4 minus 0, which is equal to H of 4. Right? So what is happening? This 0, H of 0 is, and H of 4 are same. Similarly, if you go for h of 1, you get h of 4 minus 1, h of 3. Then h of 2 is equal to h of 2, right? 4 minus 2, this is 2. Okay. So what is happening? Same. 0 and 4, h of 0 and h of 4, they are same. H of 1 and h of 3 are same, and in between you are having 2. So this is your symmetric filter. Okay. Right? So this is a type 1 filter. Similarly, when you try to design the type 2 filter, you'll be having a similar thing, h of 0, okay. So here our length is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so here if you see h of 0 equals to h of n means 5 minus 0, 5, length is 6, so order is 5. Okay, length is 6, why 6? 0 is 1, then second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So length is 6, that means our order is 1. So L minus 1 is 6 minus 1 is 5. So if you look into this equation, Hn equals to h of n minus n. So n is 5 and small n is 0. So h of 0 is equal to h of 5. Similarly, if you go for the h of 1, it should be h of 4. Then h of 2, it should be equals to h of 3. Okay. So the type 2 filter, it should follow this ideology. H of 0 is equal to h of 5, h of 1 equals to h of 4, h of 2 is equal to h of 3. Okay. So this type 1 and type 2 filter, both these filters, they have constant phase delay and constant group delay. Okay, constant phase delay and constant group delay. Okay, when we talk about the other one, other three, two types of filter, type 3 and type 4, type 3, it has an order of even, whereas the length should be odd. Okay. Okay. And it is given by Hn equals to minus of h of n minus n, capital N minus n, which is regarded as the anti-symmetric property. Okay. Type 4 also, it is having an order of odd, length of even, and it is also an anti-symmetric filter. That means our Hn is equal to minus of h of n minus n. Now what happens over here? Since there is a negative sign, so what happens? Our h of 0 is equal to minus of h of 4. Okay. h of 1 is equal to minus of h of 3. Okay, and then we have h of 2. Okay, so if you see over here in the first half, so where we are having the time indices 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So h of 0 value, whatever the value will be there, suppose it is having an amplitude of 2, then h of 4 it will be having an amplitude of minus of 2. Okay, and similarly the other coefficients should be there. Okay. In a likewise manner, we have the type 4 filter. So in the type 4 filter, what you will be having? H of 0 is equal to minus of H of 5. H of 1 is equal to minus of H of 4. H of 2 is equal to minus of H of 3. Okay. So these are the four types of filter.
So what is the length over here? So please again, length is 6 or
you tell me. In the previous case I have already told you. Anyone else who can tell?
Yeah, what is the length of the filter
in the type 4 filter which I have drawn?
Upper 2 I know, but the below 2 I want to know again, please.
It is having the same thing. Anyone else who can tell about the type 3 and type 4? What is the length? No one?
Type 3 length is 5.
For type 3, the length is 5 and type 4, length is 6.
Be a bit louder. Sunai nahi de raha.
For type 3, sir, length is 5 and type 4, length is 6, sir.
Length is?
6.
Yeah.
6.
And sir, n, small n, so it become minus h of f. So how you count in uppercase it, in type 1 it is, you did, I understand, but here how you did, so it become minus h of f, 5.
Who can discuss? Who can tell? Anyone who can tell?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please.
In type 4, when we have to find h of 0, here small n is 0 and capital N is 5. So 5 minus 0, we get h of 5. Then when small n is equal to 1, then we get minus h of 5 minus 1, which is minus h of 4, and so on.
And what about type 3?
So in type 3, we have small n equal to 0 and capital N is equal to 4. So for first case, h of 0 is equal to minus h of 4 minus 0, which is minus h of 4. In second case, small n is 1. So h of 1 is equal to minus h 4 minus 1, which is equal to minus h 4 minus 1, which is 3. minus h of 3.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes. Now, when we try to go for filter designing, in our last class, we have I have given you a hint of how we can design the filter. Say, for example, I have z equals to say 1 plus 2z inverse plus 3z to the power minus 2 plus 2z to the power minus 3 plus z to the power minus 5. Why I have given this? Because if I have to find out the HN, HN means 1, 2, 3, 2, 1.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So this is, what is the length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is the length. Right? 5 minus 1 is 4. Okay, so order of the filter is 4. So what type of filter it is?
Type 1 filter.
Yeah, it is a type 1 filter. Okay, now how do I realize it? What I have told? Yz equals to xz
h of z in
plus,
yeah,
2 xz z inverse plus 3 xz z to the power minus 2 plus 2 z to the power minus 3, sorry, xz I missed, plus xz.
Sir, z to the minus
4
power is missing.
Oh, sorry,
yeah. Sir, that, okay, 0, we can put 0, sir. 2, 0, 1.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
This should be 4, sorry.
Yes, sir. Otherwise, you can put 0, sir. Is it possible?
Kahan pe 0 put karoge?
2, 0, 1. Last name.
नहीं वो ये टू मेक एन लिनियर फिल्टर दिस शुड बी फॉलोड.
ओके सर.
एग्जैक्ट दैट इज वाज माइनस 4, सॉरी. ओके, नाउ इफ यू हैव टू रियलाइज दिस व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, एग्जैक्ट वी गो टू द एडर वी गेट वाई जेड. ओके, here we have a multiplier of 1, then z inverse we get to the adder, this is 2, then again z inverse z inverse 2, right? We have discussed this. So this is the easiest way to find out this thing, right? This is the easiest method of implementation of the filter. So this is this type of implementation of the filter or the realization of the filter, it is regarded as direct form realization. However, if you see, there are two things. One important thing, if you see, the coefficient of this filter, of this xz and coefficient of xz z to the power minus 4, they are same. Okay? Coefficient of 2 xz z inverse and coefficient of 2 xz z to the power minus 3, they are also same. However, we have used the multiplier multiple times over here. So, this direct form of realization, it is not the best way to implement the filter. Okay. So, there is another way which is called phase linear implementation, linear phase implementation. So over there, let me write down the equation again. Yz equals to xz plus 2 of xz z inverse plus 3 of xz z to the power minus 2 plus 2 of xz z to the power minus 3 plus xz into z to the power minus 4. Okay. Now, can I write it in this fashion? 1 multiplied by xz plus xz z to the power minus 4 plus of 2 multiplied by xz z inverse plus 2 xz z to the power minus 3. Sorry, this 2 will not come. Plus of 3 xz z to the power minus 2. Right? So let us implement in this fashion. First, what I will do is that I will draw the delays. Z inverse okay. So what is what we are doing? We are taking xz plus after the output we are getting this thing, the z to the power minus 4. We are adding this up. Then z inverse, so z inverse where we are having, I am having here, and z to the power minus 3 where we are having here. Okay, so I will take up the values from here. I have a multiplier of 2 over here, right? And then if you see, I am having at last, I am left with 3 xz z to the power minus 2. So z to the power minus 2 is at this point. Okay, we are having a multiplier of 3, and then I am getting the output yz. Okay. Are you getting my point? So what I have done over here, see, here I am only having 3 multipliers. Okay. However, in the direct form, how many multipliers I was having? I was having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I was having 5 number of multipliers. And in this case, I have reduced the multiplication to 3. That means I have reduced the complexity burden on the filter. So, linear phase implementation of the FIR filter it helps us in implementing the FIR filters in an efficient way, so that the complexity burden does not the complexity burden of the FIR filter, it reduces. Okay, so while we'll be doing the future studies or the future numericals, please keep this in mind. You can implement the filter either by the direct form method or by the linear phase implementation method. Both are good. However, if you look into the complexity wise, the implementation of the FIR filters using the linear phase method, it is economical as compared to the direct form implementation method. Okay. Now, designing methods, there are 4 types of designing methods. First one is Fourier series method without using window. Second is Fourier series method using window method, using window. Third is Fourier transform method without using window. And lastly, Fourier transform method using window. Okay. So these are the 4 types of designing methods where we will be using, studying the FIR filter designing methods. Okay. So the FIR filter designing methods, it will be covered from the book Digital Signal Processing by B.S. Nair. Okay. So today we will stop over here. If you have any questions, we can discuss.
Sir?
Yeah?
Sir, last time when we were solving in previous lectures, you told us about the linear method of solving filter responses.
Linear response?
No, sir.
General method.
General method.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So you were going to take some examples of it.
What examples I told?
Sir, I just asked because we are not familiar with that method. So I asked you if you could just take some examples so we could understand how to solve those type of questions.
This one you're talking about?
Where we have to put z is equal to e to the power minus omega t.
Okay. Now we will come over there. So we are getting into the system.
Okay, sir, actually that was asked
into the filters, right?
Exam.
Pardon?
Sir, actually it was asked in exam. We were given sampling frequency and we had to do that.
No. You can definitely do it over there. how you will do do the thing. It's pretty simple. I told you to find out what was the question. Can you read out?
Sir, in the question, we were given sampling frequency 100 hertz, and then sir, we were given transfer function, and we had to find the magnitude and phase response.
How you have to find out? Your sampling frequency is given. That means you can find out 0 to pi. What is the maximum legal frequency? Okay, at 0 pi by 2, another thing was given, 0 pi by 2 and pi at this radian position.
Yes,
you have been asked, na?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah, so from there you have to find out this thing. So what is the frequency component into hertz? You have to just convert the radians into the hertz. And then just you have to find out what is the amplitude response by the distance method. That was the question. I never asked you to calculate it using the other method, because I haven't started that topic yet. Okay.
So I did not understand how will we take that 100 hertz that sampling frequency, and how will we use it? Like, we have to use that frequency only during phase response?
No, during the amplitude response also.
So but for amplitude response, we just consider the distance, no? Distance of pole and distance of zeros.
Yeah, definitely. Then you have been given with the transfer function, right?
Yes, sir.
So if it is if your FS is given as 100 or 1000, it was given?
100 hertz.
Okay, if it is 100 hertz, so what is your FM? FM is 50 hertz?
50 hertz, yes sir.
So here it will be your 50 hertz.
Yes,
it was
sir.
Given, find out the response at 0 pi by 2 and pi radians. Okay, so if 50 hertz is at pi, your 0 is 0 degree, zero hertz. This is 50 hertz. Pi by 2 would be 25 hertz. Then by the placement of pole and zero, you just find out the thing, 0 to 50 hertz. This was 25 hertz. You just find out what place the poles and zeros and find out the distance, and by that calculation you just find out what is the amplitude value.
Yes sir. So we had to plot this graph also, like the frequency and the amplitude that we're getting.
And if you plot the graph, it's okay. Ultimately you had to plot the graph.
Okay,
after
sir. So
what you have to find out, HZ at 50 hertz, 0 hertz, sorry. We just asked you to find out zero radians, pi by 2 radians and pi radians. Instead of that, we just gave you the sampling frequency, and from there you just have to calculate the corresponding frequencies in hertz, and just you have to calculate HZ at those frequencies. That's it.
Okay, sir.
So I never asked anything which is out of syllabus.
Yeah. So sir, we just got confused because sampling frequency.
That's why, na? That's why,
sir,
I gave it.
Yes, sir.
Because this I have covered.
Sir.
This I have covered separately. This I have covered separately, and you people said you never had any problems. So I have to test your intelligence, na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I had one more question.
Yeah.
Like the pole or the zero, in one of the questions, pole or the zero was placed at zero at the origin. So how the phase response is affected because of that? You know that the distance,
question?
Like,
what was the question? And can we take it in the doubt clearing class, because it's already 10:05, and you
yes,
may
sir.
Have to attend the next class.
Yes, sir. Sure.
Okay. So we will discuss it in the doubt clearing class. Not a problem.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.